Jade, thanks so much for joining me for episode 8. This is episode 8 of Behind the Bulldog. Thanks again for agreeing to this, for taking some time out of your busy schedule. How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing as best as I can under these under these circumstances. So tell us, what are you up to these days, class of 2014? So it's been a while since you've been a student athlete on campus. What are you up to now?
Well, now I'm currently a PE teacher at a local high school, Porter Ridge. So that keeps me pretty busy. I coach on the side, CSA. Other than that, that's pretty much it.
What's the setup like with COVID-19? Are you teaching your PE classes in person, or what's the setup like?
So right now we're at 50% capacity. So we have a group of kids coming Monday, Tuesday, and then a different group coming Wednesday, Thursday. But then we're also teaching virtual to the kids who are not coming to school. So a little bit of both, depending on what day it is. And then every Friday is remote. So
I'm trying to envision this on a remote day where you're teaching PE. Is it jump on a Zoom and we'll do exercises on Zoom? How does that work?
Well, eventually that'll probably happen. Right now we're doing health. So we'll have like 6 weeks of health and then the rest will be PE. So what we're doing is having them do their health work online. And then when they're at school, we have them doing like exercises because they're probably not getting exercise at home.
So. Right. So what's been your reaction to COVID, and how have you tried to personally handle it with your job and just on a day-to-day level?
Well, I feel like everyone, I wasn't expecting it to last this long. But that now that it has, I guess just taking things day by day, you never know what's going to happen. I know they just changed, Union County Public Schools just changed the two, kids can go come twice a week. Mm-hmm. So being able to adapt, I guess on the fly, just like that, just taking things day by day, really.
How many years have you been at Porter Ridge?
So I started in February of 2018, but as the online teacher. So district learning, if you're taking an online class, you'll come to my classroom and you just kind of do your own work. So this is my second year as a PE teacher.
So your online class. So were you doing Zoom in 2018?
I was not. I was just making sure they were doing their classwork.
Okay.
Through Zoom.
So. I gotcha. So there was Zoom. Zoom did exist in 2018.
I'm pretty sure, yeah, because they had to have some way of communicating. So.
Gotcha.
Or I know we use Microsoft Teams, to Zoom our classes. So one of the recordings.
That's awesome. And so from the time that you grad, we'll get into your Wingate women's soccer career in just a moment, which is quite decorated, I must say. For anyone that just looks at the numbers, it's pretty impressive. But when you left Wingate as a student athlete, the time frame between when you said you started at Porter Ridge in 2018, what were you up to those 4 years?
The year after I graduated, I finished that year. I went and played soccer in Finland. Then I came back and I actually applied for grad school and got the GA position at Wingate for the women's team. So I was helping coach there, got my master's. Then after I did that, I decided I still wanted to play. So I went back to Finland. And then I came back at the end of 2017. And then the job search was fun. We'll say fun. but then I got the job at Porter Ridge. So
fantastic. And so you were in grad school at Wingate taking classes online while playing soccer in Finland?
Or? No. So I came back. I know it's kind of crazy. I came back in 2015, I think October. Mm-hmm. And then I started taking classes January of 2016, graduated 2017. So I was helping coach those 2 years with Chip and Jack. And then I decided to go back in 2018, came back October 2018, and then started. No, did I must have? Wow. Started in 2019. So February 2019. and then finished that year. Yeah. The years are combining.
Crazy.
That means you're getting old. Man, the years are combining. So yeah.
Yeah, that is crazy. And so playing in Finland, how was that?
It was fun. It was definitely an experience. I guess any time that you're able to travel abroad and learn a new culture, try to learn a new language, it's definitely an experience. I think if anyone who has the opportunity to do that definitely should take it. I grew a lot personally during that time. It was a great experience.
What was the level of competition like? How did it compare to the South Atlantic Conference?
I would say roughly the same, or maybe just a little bit above. The girls over there were a bit younger. So there was maybe, I would say, 5 to 6 girls who were between maybe 22 and 26. And then everyone else was still in high school. So literally, there was a handful that were maybe juniors and seniors in high school. So, but the level of the high school players there, I guess from what I've seen so far, the level of our high school players here is pretty different. So.
Gotcha. All right. Well, let's turn back the clock. Relive some of the glory days on campus at Wingate. You, of course, one of the most decorated, if not the most decorated, Wingate women's soccer players to come through Wingate. And you've got I could list off so many things when I looked up just how many, your goals. You've scored 66 career goals, which is tied for third most in the SAC. You led Division II in goals as a sophomore in 2012. Mm-hmm. Three-time All-American. You're the only female student athlete to win SAC Female of the Year 3 times. So when you hear these things, Jade, what do you think about the most when you hear about the career that you had at Wingate?
I wish I could go back. I don't know. It was definitely a great experience. I had great teammates around me. I would have never thought, I guess, high school me would have never thought I would have been there. So I guess being able to achieve the goals that I set, going into college, even being able to reach my childhood dream of playing professionally somewhere. I'm definitely proud of myself looking back. But again, I definitely couldn't have done that myself. I had some great players helping me along the way, great coaches helping me along the way. I wish I could literally turn back time and go back. So,
yeah. And it's funny. I was talking to Jack Vundum today. We're recording this on October 7th. Mm-hmm. And I asked him, I said, what's Jade's best attribute on the pitch? I know you've got the answer for me because he was an assistant when you were playing. And do you have any idea what he might have said to that question?
Hope it'd be nice. I guess my determination.
Maybe he said that's a great guess. He said just straight up, Jack Vundum did. He said scoring goals, and you had 66 of them. How were you able to be so effective in that department?
Practice. I know there were sometimes I would stay after and just literally receive a cross and try to finish. There'd be times I'd go a couple games without scoring and I'd beat myself up over it, but I definitely practiced a lot. Again, there was some players we played with that would give me perfect crosses. So I maybe was in the right place at the right time. Mm-hmm. But I just know if there was a ball between me and another player, I was going to do whatever I could to get there. And I was going to make sure that I got there. But really, I guess my determination to score, I would set goals and I would try to reach those goals, literally in goals.
That's really awesome to hear that determination factor. Do you have a favorite goal from your career?
There's a lot that kind of pop into my mind. I guess the best one the most memorable one for me would be scoring in the SAC tournament against LMU my junior year to kind of push us through to the NCAA tournament and then going on to the Elite Eight that year. That one sticks out to me the most. It was with under a minute left. Crazy environment. So I guess that one.
That year was, obviously you just alluded to it, it was a special year, mm-hmm. making it to the quarterfinals, Southeast Region champs. And I want to say it was round two, if I remember correctly, the penalty kicks victory. Oh, yeah.
Columbus State, yep.
Yeah, tell me about that match.
I think that might have been the first year we actually played Columbus State. Definitely a tough team, very aggressive team. I think, I want to say we went up early, and then they came back and scored in the second half. I could be wrong there. But I know in the locker room before the game, we were all hype. We were dancing. We were singing. We were ready to go. But definitely that was a tough game. We came out of it on top, but it was not an easy ride to get there. So
what do you remember most about that team, that 2013 team that made it all the way to the quarterfinals in the NCAA tournament?
See, I know that year we had a lot of seniors. We didn't want to let those seniors down. But I would say we were all on the same page. Starting preseason, we all came in, killed the fitness tests.
That's always right. That's always the best thing is when you just absolutely destroy that at the beginning.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly. So we all were literally just pretty much each other's biggest cheerleaders. I don't even know. Like that was a great group of girls. We didn't want to let someone else down. So we wanted to make sure we did everything we could do individually so everyone could take it as far as we could.
You also, and Jack mentioned Caitlin Brunworth as well as somebody who's right up there with you. I mean, one of the best women's soccer players to come through Wingate, and you had a chance to play with her. What type of dynamic did you two have on the pitch?
I don't know how Brunny would do the things that she would do with the ball, but her ability to keep the ball, take a player on, make them look silly, and then find the open pass to keep possession with the ball under three people on her, just kind of dribble around them. I guess her leadership on the ball, on the field, definitely just helped get us where we needed to be. She was a big presence in the midfield, caused a lot of teams some trouble. So having her there, easy ball to feed through. Mm-hmm. It was special to play with her.
Yeah, I mean, it sounds like it. I see some clips, and it's just impressive what you all were able to do. And now, Jade, when you look at the time that you got there, 2011, and then to 2014, it was you and LR. It was Wingate and LR. I mean, that I can't imagine. I've been here for about 3 years, and I know that rivalry exists big time. Mm-hmm. What was it like when you were playing? Because I mean, you two were at the top of the SAC standings literally almost every year.
Yeah, I think it was, they were first in regular season play. We were always second. But everyone knew that was going to be a big game. So trying to prepare the younger ones for it before it even got there, was big, mm-hmm. for us. I don't really remember the scores of them all, but it was always a tough game. Definitely our toughest game. I know the SAC has kind of changed since then, but they were definitely a very physical team to play against. They would always get us in the regular season, but we somehow always came back and got them in the tournament, except for 1 year, but we won't talk about that. But yeah, definitely a tough, tough team. Good rival, really, not too far away either. So
yeah, no doubt. And it was crazy just to look at it. They had the regular season title all 4 years you were there, but you and your squad winning three SAC tournament titles. So like you said, what was the best one out of those three SAC tournament titles?
I don't know. They were all great.
They were all special. I feel like that's a very hard question.
I could answer like my first 2011, the first time I think the women's team won. So that was special. And then we lost sophomore year. Junior year, we won in under a minute. So that was special. My senior year, we won in PKs. So that was also special. In my senior year, it led us to the NCAA tournament. So I guess they all were pretty special in their own little way. But yeah, that is a tough question.
That is. I'm asking all these hard questions, Jade. I'm sorry.
No, that's okay.
So you went to Piedmont, right? Piedmont High School, which is basically right down the road. Yep. So how early did you know that you were wanting to go to Wingate?
Not that early. I would always grow up going to the Wingate basketball camps. I think I went to one soccer camp. It was when Junior was my coach. And so
shout out Junior. Great guy.
So he had our team go to the camp. But really, I think I committed late fall of my senior year of high school because I was looking around. But I'm so glad I chose Wingate. They led me to the best opportunities. So definitely made a good choice there.
So was it a hard choice? Like, where else were you looking to go to college?
I was looking at Coastal, Wilmington, Western, ECU because my brother was there, but then he ended up leaving. So that really, I just looked at those four.
For soccer?
Yeah.
Okay.
So Wingate was close. They allowed me to play basketball my freshman year, so I didn't want to give that up quite yet. But it felt homey. Like, I've been there growing up my whole life. So it was just a sense of home. I knew the people there. The coach at the time, Coach Gary Kernine, was one of my club coaches. So I knew him. I knew Hamill. So it was just a good environment to kind of step into.
Right. Yeah. And so you were a hooper.
Basketball
player, as you just mentioned. Did you always want to play basketball in college? Like, when did it shift to where you were like, I'm full-blown soccer?
That's a funny question. Well, I didn't really want to quit, but it got to the point where my body was taking too much, and so I spoke with the soccer coach, and he goes, well, you probably should quit and just focus on soccer. So that's how that conversation went. So then I was no longer a basketball player.
I got you. So this
was probably the best decision for me, was to not play.
Okay. And was that conversation was with a coach in high school or?
No, it was my sophomore year of college.
Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah. So you after your freshman year of college at Wingate, you were still grappling with like which one you were going to really pursue?
Oh, no, it was definitely going to be soccer, but I didn't want to give up basketball. Like, basketball was just fun for me. But I like soccer. It's more aggressive. It's outside, a little bit better than basketball. So
That's cool. Did you go to any women's soccer games at Wingate when you were a kid?
I did. I think I went to two, and then I remember going to a men's game when they played in the football stadium.
So wow, that's
one year. I don't know when they did that, but I remember it was in the football stadium. So that's the first game I ever went to. Couldn't tell you when.
Wow, that's
a while ago.
That sounds like it was 20 years ago.
Yeah, probably. So
that is crazy. So when you think about we always hear one dog, that one dog phrase that comes up, when you hear the one dog phrase, where does your mind go?
I guess straight to the community that Wingate really is. The team is literally like a family. So when I hear one dog, it's literally bringing back all the memories of all the different teammates that I've had. All the good memories we shared, all the bad memories we shared. Literally having that community around you. It's, I know you hear it at every school you go to, but it's like legit. Right. It is a small community. It's so homey. So that's where I go.
You got the chance to, I know you mentioned coaching at Wingate a little bit a few years ago, but this past year you got a chance to be with Jack Vundum on the sidelines, as he was at the time the interim head coach. Now he is the head coach. Yep. huge congrats. I mean, I've said it to him many yep. times. So tell me what it was like being on the sidelines with Coach Vundum for the 2019 season, a season in which the women's team was extremely successful. Mm-hmm. 15 win season.
It definitely brought back great memories. Jack is a great coach. He knows how to set the culture, get what he wants out of the girls. He gave me a ton of confidence in the coaching environment. So that was something that, you know, I thank him for. But just being alongside of him, he's been a great friend even before last year. It was fun. Like he made it was fun, and that's what it really should be. It should be fun.
Yes. I mean, I see him interact. Going to a couple of practices myself, I just, the way he literally practices mm-hmm. with the team. Yeah. I don't know if that's normal,
he still
but
thinks he's in his prime. He's always, you know, complaining, pulled his hammy or broke his ankle, something the next day. But yeah, he literally practices with them.
Which is, I mean, that's a great tactic. It's exceptional. When you were a student athlete at Wingate, did you ever think like that guy, Jack Vundum, he's going to be the head coach of a school one day, let alone it be Wingate?
I knew he would make a great coach. He was a great assistant coach when I had him for those couple years, but I guess I wouldn't have thought that he would still be at Wingate, but now, like I couldn't think of another person more deserving of that title than him. So I knew wherever he would have gone, he definitely would have been a coach. He would have done great wherever, but now that it's Wingate, it's awesome. So
no doubt. And he certainly has already brought the program back to where it's supposed to be, where it was when you were there after a tough 2018 season. What do you believe was so great about the connection that you two had on the sidelines as coaches? Was there something specific? Was it the communication? Like what allowed you two to click on the sidelines last year, do you think?
Like me and him or like with the team?
Yeah, like you and him working together with the team, but specifically, yeah, you and him, what allowed you all to work really well?
I think we had such a great friendship before. I could trust him. He could trust me. I knew that he was going to do whatever needed to be done for the benefit of the team. And he knew that I would have his back no matter what. If he wanted to try that, we would try it. If I had an idea and he wasn't so sure of it, we might try it. And then we might not try it again. But definitely the trust, the communication, just having that bond before even stepping out onto the field definitely helps.
And you having that opportunity to be on the sidelines and seeing the talent that exists currently with the women's soccer program, whenever the squad gets back, hopefully, obviously on pace to come back in February, can you just give us some insight what you think the future holds for this team? Because I mean, 15 wins last year, it seems like they're right back into doing things that your teams were once doing.
I definitely think that, you know, the future is theirs. Whatever they set their mind to, I believe that they will be able to achieve that. they have some great players on that team, players I wish I played with. So
like who?
A little bit older. Oh, definitely Kristen in the back, one of the best defenders I've ever seen. Chandler, aggressive. Last year, Abby, great in goal, great leader. I could go on and on. McKenna in the middle or on the wing, super quick.
Caitlin Cox coming on strong.
I would not want to go into a tackle with her at all. She would absolutely clobber me. Who else? I'm trying to think. Morgan in the middle.
Yeah.
Let's see. I'm trying to see, like, faces.
I mean, everybody's really – when you think about it, everyone's coming back.
Yeah, everyone. Literally, they played as a team, and you couldn't really pick out one girl. Like, if we stop that one girl, they'll be done. No, it's like, oh, that girl. But then you have to worry about that win and that win. Like, they all were so special in their own little way that it just clicked, and it was phenomenal last year. So – I don't even remember what the first question was. I just kind of went off on a tangent there. Sorry.
No, it was just talking about the future.
I think they have a great future ahead of them. I really hope this season gets on the underway soon. I know I set my practice schedules opposite days of games so I can make sure I can attend as many games as I can, just to watch and like watch to see how they do.
Yeah,
I'm excited. So,
you, I assume then you won't be on the sidelines as an assistant coach like you were last year, correct?
No, I'm just gonna sit back and watch. But if there's something I see, I could just text Jack.
Yeah. That's.
I know he's doing a great job. Abby's doing a great job. I know Sam. I don't know if he still helps out just a little bit, but he's all over it. So they have a great little staff over there, so they're doing great things.
And the playing surface looks tremendous, by the way. I did see some pictures. Yep.
I saw them as well. I wish I could go back and play on it. So
yeah,
it looks really good out there.
A couple more questions for you, Jay, before I let you go. Again, this is episode 8 of Behind a Bulldog, and it's really been awesome to hear some of the memories and things that you were a part of when you were on campus at Wingate. When it comes to, let's step away from soccer for a second, just the atmosphere at Wingate as just being a student, right? Student athlete. What are some of your favorite memories, whether it was a class that you excelled in or just something off the pitch that you cherish the most about your time at Wingate?
Let's see. Definitely class-wise, DJ, Dr. Johnson, by far my favorite professor. I was really big into intramural sports, so I was able to play basketball, still play basketball somewhat. The team I was on did win 4 championships in a row.
So
very proud about that. We had a great team. Some of the soccer girls were on there as well. I guess – really just hanging out, literally having that community around you. You wouldn't go anywhere without seeing someone you knew. And so I think that's the great part about it. You would go to the cafeteria by yourself and then always have someone to sit with. You knew class sizes were small, so I really liked that as well. You really were able to get to know your professors. So it was all around great experience, especially as a student as well.
Yeah, I think the campus vibe when it comes to that small intimate setting where you're able to form those relationships with your professors first and foremost certainly is beneficial. Now I've got to mention, I don't think I said your last name yet, but Jade Montgomery. And is it Jade Montgomery Cheron? We'll get into that in just a second. Or are you Jade, just straight up Jade Cheron?
It's just Jade Cheron, but I guess on my paperwork for now, especially teaching, I'm going to hear Montgomery for at least 4 more years because of the kids I had last year.
Right.
But yep, it's just Jade Cheron.
And that'll lead me into this question. I actually had the privilege of calling football games with Cornel Cheron, who's now your husband, and you all got married earlier this year, which is amazing. So first and foremost, congratulations
thank you.
On that. So, yeah, how was the wedding? I know it was obviously COVID was going on, but what did it mean to, finally get the wedding to a date and make it happen? What was that like?
It was definitely stressful leading up to it. Just knowing we have to change the date, people aren't going to be able to come, things like that. But my parents actually threw us a small wedding in our backyard on one of the dates that we kind of wanted. And then we kind of pushed back the original wedding because I know his family's from all over. So they weren't able to travel when we actually wanted to have the wedding. So we had to push it back like a lot of other people had to do. But my parents kind of built like their own little wedding for us in the backyard. And so we got married then, but then I guess got married twice and did our beach wedding with his family. So I guess it all worked out. So 2020 for us has been great, but then everything else is going on. But it was definitely, it was awesome.
Yeah, that's amazing. And Cornel, obviously a former Wingate Bulldog, of course, former defensive back on the football team. So I've got to ask, right? Like, when did you all first meet?
We were pretty good friends throughout undergrad. So I met him sophomore year, just hanging out, I guess, with my roommate. He was always over. Uh-huh. And we just had this really big friend group and we would always do everything together. And then leading into grad school, when I came back from Finland, we were both kind of trying to find ourselves, going through kind of rough patches, I would say. And then he has always been one of my best friends. He was always there for me. We would always have fun together. And then it just kind of, here we are. So
awesome.
It's been a great ride. So
that's great to hear. And Cornel and yourself, obviously former Wingate Bulldogs, coming together post college. So again, congratulations on the marriage and really cool stuff. So let's wrap up, Jade, with this question that I have for you before we turn the page on episode 8. Again, great episode, by the way. I appreciate the insight.
Where
do you see yourself career-wise in, let's say, 5-10 years? Do you want to continue on this path of like being a PE teacher or at a high school, like get into coaching? Where do you kind of see yourself going in the next 5 years or so?
You know, growing up, I never thought I would ever be a teacher. But now that I am a teacher, I absolutely love it. So I definitely think I will continue on the path of being a teacher. I'll probably stay in high school. I like being able to, you know, joke around with the kids and someone's being a smart aleck, you can be a smart aleck back and they think it's funny. Just being able to build that relationship with the kids, I guess being a role model to them as well. And it'll also allow me to still coach. So definitely I think I'll stay with PE.
So a little bit of both. Yeah.
Yeah. Being a PE teacher, it's like the best thing in the world. You can wear shorts and a t-shirt. You get to play games with the kids. I mean, it doesn't really get much better than that. So.
Yeah. And I remember my PE classes in high school and middle school, just being ridiculously competitive. So I'm sure, you know, you're able to.
Yeah, but it has to be competitive. Everything is always, you got to win.
Yeah.
You got to learn how to lose too. But yeah, it's definitely make everything into a game, more competitive. They seem to enjoy that. So
awesome. Well, Jade, thank you so much for joining me for episode 8 of Behind a Bulldog. Really appreciate the insight on everything, getting to know you a little bit better. And I certainly hope nothing but the best with you the rest of 2020. Hopefully things turn a corner, you know, in our country and we see change. Thank you. And look forward to watching the Wingate women's soccer team back out on the pitch whenever that time comes. Any final thoughts before you go?
Nope, I'm looking forward to that as well. Thank you, and thank you for bringing back so many memories, so many great memories. So it's been fun.